What's up, guys? This is Point Made, here to give you a Napoleon Total War Online Battle Runner 41. This is also a faction request. I'm supposed to play as Denmark, and my opponent, Gran_Pope, is playing as France. I'm the only one that's supposed to use the underscore. I will show him the true power of the underscore. Okay. Well, I guess you can call this a battle for the usage of the underscore in our names. So, I'm going to play as Denmark, and my opponent, Grandpa, is going to play as France. Since he chose France, and I was supposed to choose Denmark, I figured, alright, I know France's weakness, so... But I know this faction's weakness as well, so... I'm outmatched in almost every genre. Cavalry, guards, line infantry, and rifles. So I figured, alright, I'll just get the long range and bring more infantry. And I have to bring less cavalry so I could bring more infantry, so I wanted to max out the guard types that I can bring just so I could stand up to France. And so I have 9 units of infantry, 4 of which are guard type units, 5 are regular line infantry, which are very weak compared to France's infantry units. And my opponent brought almost the best infantry of France instead of the old guard units and the guard seamen. How could he not bring the guard seamen? That bastard. That heartless bastard. Alright, I'm just joking, but still, that's very heartless to forget that special unit. Every male knows that that unit completes us in a battle. Alright. It helps penetrate their center, or the rear, or the flank, or wherever. God. Well, my opponent is going to bring 6 units of Lancers. So, I am outmatched and he's gonna outmaneuver me. I have nothing to counter this threat. So, it's obvious he's gonna want me to split my forces to focus on his cavalry on my wings. Then he's gonna do a little frontal infantry push to try and overwhelm my forces. So, I believe that's his main strategy. That's why he didn't even bother getting some chassiers or Voltigas. So, he's gonna completely overwhelm my rifles. But luckily for me, I play stakes, so that's gonna absorb some of their devastating accurate shots. And I'm gonna retreat him a little. So I'm going to take my reserves and start surrounding his forces on the flank. I'm going to send my lifeguards on horse to attack him from the flank. He's going to start his lancer charges on my guys, and I have no choice but to form square and hopefully overcome this threat on my center, which is his superior infantry, and that's very tough to beat. But I want to focus the majority of my attention on those lancers. So it's obvious he's going to out-micro me, since I had to deal with his units from the front and behind. So I brought his lancers in the range of my infantry by making him chase my lifeguards of horse into the range of my infantry. So that's a little good teamwork to go. So after they gave off a volley or two, I made him form to a square, and I have a secondary line in front to give him backup. So I'm using a lot of reserve line tactics here, so supporting line tactics. It's really good to do. I mean, it's a good strategy just in case your opponent gets through your lines. You have a secondary defense behind your primary defense. And it's overwhelming not only to your opponent, but it's overwhelming to even guard-type units if they try to assault your center. So he lost so many of his lancers instantly. He sent 3 to attack my lone lifeguards of horse, and he has only 2 left that are very depleted morale, and they're continuing their assault. It looks like my heavy cav is disordering his troops on the flank, so I'm going to push up there. So there goes one of these units, and he's going to start pushing up on this flank. I guess he sees a lot of my troops occupied in square formation, so he's like, alright, I'm just going to push up, overwhelm his rifles, and then push onto his weak infantry. So it looks like he's going to go for a 3rd Lancer charge against my infantry. I'm just going to keep on repositioning my infantry to try to support that square formation. I just want to get rid of his Lancers, then I'll deal with his guard types later. But the way he attacks is very overwhelming, especially for Denmark. So I believe reserve tactics and staying your ground in the center of the map and waiting for them to attack is the best strategy that you can do as Denmark against France. So it looks like he was going to reposition my flank here, and I didn't want to reposition because I knew he was just going to get free shots, so I just thought, oh, what the hell, let me just melee him, because I know I'm just going to lose if I try to reposition it, because he's only going to get the free shots. And I saw his lancers trying to go after that lifeguard of foot in melee with his young guard, so he was going to try and send some guard chassiers to support him. gave off a shot, and he was going to do a little devastating charge from behind too, but I redirected their charge, my infantry's charge, onto that chassis unit. Looks like I messed up on some mistakes, like the units were staring off into space on one of my flanks, and they could be shooting at his flank. So my lifeguards of foot are very disorganized on the flank. I'm in melee with his guard chassiers and his young guard, and he's still trying to overwhelm me on my center, but it looks like I'm going to force him to make a new front. He's going to run away his guard chassiers and try and reposition for another secondary charge against my units, because he knows cav charges are very useful instead of just going to sustain melee. So I'm just going to use my guards, my general staff, to do some hit-and-run tactics onto those young guard and melee with my lifeguards of horse. I mean, lifeguards of foot. He's going to try and take out my general staff. So I'm just going to run my general staff away, and I'm just going to push up on this flank train, reposition point-blank range of his units on the flank. And it looks like some of my forces are occupied down the center. They're being overwhelmed, and he's going to keep on cap-charging them with his lancers. So I'm going to keep on running away my general staff on this flank, keep on counter-charging his guard chassiers and his young guard in melee with my lifeguards at foot. I'm going to push up on this flank, and he's starting to overwhelm my center very badly. I mean, he keeps on disrupting my forces with his lancers, and he keeps on shooting at him with his elite infantry or his Swiss foot. So on the flank, it looks kind of even right now. I inspired my unit of lifeguards at foot. I'm going to form into a quick square. He routed one of my units down the center. I thought I was losing at first because I saw multiple units starting to route. But I'm doing good on the flanks while he's doing good on my center. So I won on this flank. That melee fight's over with. Now I'm doing a lot of damage on his other flank. He's being overwhelmed by my lifeguards of foot. So I'm just going to keep on pushing up. And it looks like he's going to retreat soon enough. Two of my units are starting to come back from routing. Two of my rifles. And these are my sharpshooters. They're very accurate, and they're... I prefer the 100 range units because they have 90 men in there, and it forces you to be aggressive against your opponent if he brings rifles. But since my opponent didn't bring any rifles, he was forced to just use his cav and try and split up my rifle force, but I didn't, so I kept my rifles on eye with his infantry. So it looks like he's going to start to retreat. I saw that he was going to retreat, so I sent one of my lifeguards of foot into melee with his guys. As he's running away, my lifeguards of foot are just going to give chase on foot just to get him to sustain melee so they wouldn't keep on running away. And I targeted one of his Polish legions. And it looks like he's going to try and form into a square. I'm just going to run away my general staff from that. He still has one depleted unit of lancers. So I'm going to keep on... Ooh, I routed one of his units. Alright, sweet. Let's chase him some more. Chase him in melee. So he's going to cav charge one of my units. I'm going to try and go in melee. And they route. Alright, that's the last of his cavalry. So the units that I had on his flanks originally, I'm going to keep on repositioning them to face his flanks. Attacking his Polish legion in melee with my lifeguards of foot. So that's keeping them in place for a bit. Usually your opponents don't react to an attack like that in melee. So it's good to just reposition your units just to give them support that are in melee with a superior infantry type. Especially against a guard type. So I'm going to rush my rifle force up. Make them... Pretty much I'm not going to use any protection for my rifles. Just maybe one or two line infantry units to protect the flank of them. But that's only a little allusion to my opponent real quick. So he'll think that he's being surrounded, and he'll keep on backing up and take free shots from behind as he runs away by my rifles. So if he really shouldn't have run away. He should have just kept on attacking and see what happens. But he wanted to form the front because he saw he was being overwhelmed on his flanks. So it's understandable what he was thinking. So he was repositioning his Swiss guard on the flank, so I pushed up my lifeguards of foot. I wish they would give Denmark some better rifles, or at least more cav choice. They don't have that much cav choice, just light cav and heavy cav. That's the only choice you have. Three units of cav that you can choose from. That's a big variety. I mean, Denmark back then was awesome. Like in Medieval 2, Total War. I mean, you had so many choices for infantry, but for the new Total War games, not much. So they're really killing off the minor nations, seriously. I mean, these guys were a force to be reckoned with, and now, not so much. I guess back then they weren't, but still, they were pretty useful. So, as you see, he's just going to keep on running away, and I'm just going to keep on repositioning him on his flank. And this is the last part of his running. I skipped the portion where he kept on running, which was a good 3 to 5 minutes. And he stopped to say, GG, he typed in RE, which is short for a rematch. I said, nah, because I really don't want to face another type of army like that with a Denmark build. So, this was a fun match against my opponent, Gran_Pope.